Good evening. First, let me say, I'm on the clock already, aren't I? Okay, so I'm gonna tell my joke really quickly. Clearly, this is a night for young people because I am not so young. It's Friday night. A drink and sleep is about all I do at about this time on Friday. And it's warm in here. I don't know if I'm going through the change, but I don't think I am. And so this is like a young, very cool people event. So I hope you will like what I share with you today. I'm Diane Billings Burford, and I'm the Chief Service Officer for the City of New York. And what that means is I head up NYC Service. In 2009, Mayor Bloomberg made a promise in his State of the City address that we were going to answer President Obama's call for a new era of service. We were going to be the city to figure out how we would consistently and efficiently use volunteers towards addressing our most pressing needs. First Deputy Mayor Patty Harris, using her considerable influence, probably conducted one of the more thorough scans of our city over the course of about 3 to 4 months. We had assessments, we had McKinsey come in, do a 60-day assessment, we collected data. We surveyed 1,500 New Yorkers, we met with not-for-profits and for-profits as far as how do they use volunteers and where could the government be helpful. And so on April 20th, this image you see here is April 20th, 09, we launched NYC Service. NYC Service is a division of the mayor's office with three main goals. We make it easier for more New Yorkers to volunteer, we connect volunteers to what we think matters the most, and we're trying to build this ethic of service across our city. We want to be the strategy to get service to respond to local needs. We want to be transformational and change in some ways the way our local government works and says, residents are not necessarily only consumers and clients, but in fact, they become partners and leaders in helping us to address community issues. And so that's, in a nutshell, what we are. I would like to say, and I want to say this, NYC Service is a part of the government. We push the government to think differently, but I am a mayoral-appointed government worker. Today, we operate 21 different initiatives over 6 impact areas. Helping our neighbors in need, strengthening our communities, emergency preparedness, education, health, and the environment. When I was asked to do this talk, I was asked to talk about a bright urban idea that's having collective impact. And I would love to tell you that NYC Service is that bright urban idea, but in fact, it is not. We are lucky enough at this point that we have been replicated both in suburban areas and in urban areas. We exist in 30 cities across the country. Team London has just launched with a model similar to ours. Madrid is working on it, and hopefully I'll get a chance to go to Athens, Greece before the end of the year. So NYC Service is not the bright urban idea that has led to collective impact. But one of our lead environmental initiatives, Cool Roofs, is. Cool Roofs is an initiative that promotes and facilitates the coating of dark roofs white. And we do that to reduce the energy consumption of buildings, to reduce our CO2 emissions, and to fight the urban heat island effect. I meant to start this speech by setting up an expectation, so I'm gonna say it now. This is not a scientific speech. I feel like there's scientists in the audience. That's not what I'm doing here. In my mind, Cool Roofs is where science meets civic engagement. And that is what I want to talk about today, places where we can have science meet civic engagement and have a collective impact. So here's how Cool Roofs work. Individuals coat roofs. It lowers the roof surface temperature. The building reduces energy consumption. Cool roofs help to mitigate the urban heat island effect. And then globally, if we get enough cool roofs, we'll combat climate change and we'll help to cool the globe. And then everybody's happy. In truth, that is what we're aiming to do. But here are the principles that underlie NYC Cool Roofs. NYC Service taps what we call the power of the people, this desire for people to volunteer and figure out a way to make a difference. We support and we engage the New York City not-for-profit community. We really call on our for-profit sector to help us be partners in conquering this, and we require interagency collaboration. With people on board, research, and facts, me convincing the lawyers that I could find someone to provide insurance to let people on roofs, we launched our pilot in September of 09 with Mayor Bloomberg and with former Vice President Al Gore. on what was possibly like the hottest day in the world. It was unbelievable, but we were able to see the impact of the cool roof immediately. And so for our pilot, we had 244 volunteers, and we coated 100 square feet of roof right here actually in Long Island City. We started at the Long Island City YMCA, and then we also coated the roof of LaGuardia Community College. And the pilot, we learned a lot of things, and we used it to launch what we were doing now. And the pilot, it was NYC Service, the Mayor's Office of Operations, and CEC, a wonderful not-for-profit that operates in New York. It is worth noting that our first model did not include a major partner that we have now, which is the Department of Buildings. And this is key. The Department of Buildings has the authority because it regulates the building code. They also had really important research. They were the people that came to us and said, we have about 579 million square feet of roof across the city that need to be coated. And we knew from them that those square feet were on about 226,000 buildings. We also brought on other partners, such as Green City Force and Sustainable South Bronx. We found in our program a way to help build pathways for people to enter into the green economy. So all that being said, in 2010, we launched our citywide effort. We set the goal of coating 1 million square feet of rooftop annually. We rolled out really in four particular groups. We really wanted to impact public low-income housing, qualified not-for-profit organizations, building owners who were looking for qualified vendors to coat their roofs that didn't qualify for us to put volunteers on their roofs, and individual homeowners that wanted to do it themselves. As I said earlier, actually I didn't say it, NYC Service, we are based on what we call impact volunteerism, and it has three components. We think that if we use government money, which I do, to engage volunteers, it has to be based on impact volunteerism. There has to be a clear need, we have to have identified a best practice, and we have to set goals and measure our progress towards those goals periodically. So I'd like for us to take a look at Cool Roofs from that impact volunteerism model. The need. When Mayor Bloomberg came to office a long time ago, we had a growing population, an aging infrastructure, a changing economy, climate change, and we really felt the city had to be deliberate in addressing these things. And so our answer to that was Plan YC. And thankfully in 07, Plan YC launched way before NYC Service did. And Plan YC really did us the favor of clearly identifying the need, doing a lot of the research on best practices, and setting this overarching goal of reducing our carbon emission by 30% by 2030. Just to share something with you, in New York City, unlike a lot of cities in the US, most of our carbon emissions do not come from cars. And they don't necessarily come from plants. But we have old buildings that consume a lot of energy. And so if we're going to tackle this problem in New York City, we have to tackle our buildings and the energy that they consume. And then lastly, because we are an urban area and we are dense, we are impacted by the urban heat island effect, which is shown here. And it increases ambient temperatures and it creates more stress, especially on our power grid during the summer. So those were all the needs that Plan YC laid out for us clearly, and we felt like what we needed to do was reduce local air temperatures, reduce peak electric power usage, reduce power plant emissions, and reduce heat trapped in the atmosphere, which was leading to the urban heat island effect. Another clear need, interestingly enough, I love the number of people that are here tonight, but another clear need is that New Yorkers, your average New Yorker, had no idea. Right? They didn't, and I'm one of those people. When I came to this job and someone said Cool Roof to me, I was like, what are you talking about? So your average New Yorker, whereas they understood conceptually something like climate change was going on, understanding exactly what the problem was, and more importantly, that there were steps we could take to impact this problem, we felt like that was something, that was a need, that was lacking, and we had to address that. So best practices. Coating a roof is a best practice. For us in particular, it was a best practice because we set the goal of coating 1 million square feet of rooftop white. Because of our budget and because of our timeline, the Cool Roof season runs from May till about October. You can only do it on days that stay above 55 degrees, and you can't do it if it rains. And so because of that, cool roofing and our, because of that and our budget, cool roofing made the most sense as opposed to a green roof. Just a little background. Cool roofs is just like wearing light clothing. Just like light clothing cools us down, coating a rooftop cools it down. Traditional dark roofs can reach someplace like 150 degrees Fahrenheit on a really hot day. Cool roofs typically stay about 50 degrees cooler. And of course, the higher the temperature on the roof, the higher the temperature in the building, the more energy you have to use to cool the building. So what we really want to change when we cool roof a building is something called a SRI, a solar, I always get this word wrong, reflectance index. And it has two parts, solar reflectance and thermal emissions. And really the question is, how much sunlight can the roof reflect and how efficiently can it get rid of the heat that it takes in? And so that's what we're looking to combat with cool roofs. Volunteer best practices, what we learned in our pilot. It was actually hard to get individuals to come out every day. So we found groups, wonderful corporate groups. Tonight with us here is ING, who's done tons of corporate cool roofs with us. We found groups from corporate groups to colleges to churches. And when they signed up, we had a steady workforce that would come and show up in the right numbers. When we sign up individuals, we sign up double, knowing that half won't show up. Public awareness best practices, we got hip. We use far more social media with cool roofs. It's so funny, when I first came to this job, I was like, oh my goodness, look at this marketing budget. It's the same as my salary, that's crazy. And they're like, no, it is your salary, you're it. So look how those overlapped. So we launched a Cool It Yourself campaign, a do-it-yourself website, and we use social media quite a bit. And then the last best practice I wanna share is our building identification best practice. We use a lot of partners to help us identify the right buildings. So another way that we engage with our corporate partners is a lot of corporate entities, they fund not-for-profits through their philanthropic arms. And usually they were great entrees to a bunch of not-for-profits that we could go to. We also use buildings to figure that out. And we really targeted NYCHA and other low-income and affordable housing places. With the need identified, best practices hammered out, we ended up with our current version of cool roofs. We had dreamed it. Lord, I had fought for it. We built it and we've made it real. It's a collaboration between NYC Service and buildings. It supports and encourages building owners to coat their rooftops white. And we've been using the thing that brings NYC Service into it is that this work is done by volunteers. And even people that choose to do this for themselves, they're doing it because they think it's better for their building, but we see it as a service for our city as well. So the last thing I want to talk about is measuring our impact. Again, we think measuring our impact is vital. Someone asked me, oh, do you think measuring your impact is vital on election day? I'm like, no, actually, I pay taxes. I think measuring our impact is vital on April 15th, every time I look at how much money I pay in taxes. And so I think we use taxpayers' money and we ought to be able to show our results on what we do. So we had the need. Here is how we've done. With our goal of coating 1 million square feet per year, we've met that happily every year, sometimes blood, sweat, and tears to get there. We think on the public awareness campaign, we have a lot more to do, but we're really excited. We've had more than 150 individuals coat their own roofs, which accounts for about 1.4 million square feet of rooftop. More importantly, we feel fairly certain a lot more people are coating their roofs and not going to our Jazzy website and reporting it. And so we think that number is just a fraction of what has been done. Since our inception, we've had about 5,100 volunteers come up and coat buildings with us. We have always exceeded our pretty high goal, and now we have coated 4.2 million square feet of rooftop white. After much research, it has been decided that on average, every 2,500 square feet of rooftop coated white is accounts for a reduction of 1 ton of CO2. And that's how we fight climate change. Therefore, we think that we have reduced carbon emissions through this project by approximately 954.97 though I'm not trying to be exact, metric tons. To better conceptualize this statistic, take a look at the map behind me. One car emits approximately 6 metric tons of CO2 per year. This means in our current state, the work we have done is now equivalent to 136 cars being taken off the road annually. We have helped to encourage more aggressive regulation on this front with the passage of Local Law 21 in 2011, which now requires new developments and older buildings to have more reflective roofs. And our bright idea of reducing the colossal carbon emissions offenders in our city buildings through a coordinated civic engagement has accomplished a great deal. But there is more impact to have. We know that there are more ways to measure the impact that we can have. We're happy to have Columbia on board, and now Princeton has come on board to help us figure out what more we can measure and what more we could do to have more of an impact. And I wouldn't be much of a chief service officer if I did not end with this. This is a direct message to everyone in the room. We'd like you to come and join us, continue, so you could be cool too. So I thank you so much, and that's Cool Roofs.